Welcome back. Problem 14-30. This problem is taken from chapter number 14, Energy Methods, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbler. So statement is determine the vertical displacement of end B of the cantilever 661 T6 aluminum alloy rectangular beam. Consider both shearing and bending strain energy. So you can see this is a cantilever beam having a point load 150 kilonewton at end B. The cross-section of this cantilever beam is rectangular, height is 300 millimeter while weight is 100 millimeter. So you have to consider both shearing and bending strain energy, and then you have to find the displacement of this point B, which is delta B. So you can see due to this load, this beam will bend like this. So this will be the delta B, which we will have to find. So let's start with the solution. So we know that total strain energy, including shearing energy, will be Ui due to shear plus strain energy due to bending. So we'll find this strain energy due to shearing as well as strain energy due to bending. For that, I have to cut this beam at a distance of x from this end B. Clear? And we will draw the free body diagram. So let me draw the free body diagram. This is the beam. This is the distance x. This is point B having a point load of 150 kilonewton. So when you cut this beam, you will be having a shear force and you will be having a moment M. At this is point O. So we'll first find this moment by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all moment about point O is equal to zero, and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point O, one moment is due to 150 and perpendicular distance is x, and this is producing clockwise moment, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 150 into perpendicular distance x. The another moment is due to this external reaction moment, which is counterclockwise and is taken as positive. And sum of all this moment about point O is equal to zero. So from here we will get moment is equal to 150 times x. Now what will about shear force? So we'll also find this shear force by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So V minus 150, that is in kilonewton, into 10 raised to power 3 is equal to zero. So from here we will get the shear force equal to 150 into 10 raised to power 3 newton. Okay, now you have both this value. So what we will do is that we will first find this shearing strain energy. So shearing strain energy. So we know that strain energy due to shear, vertical shear, is equal to integral of 0 to L Fs V square into dx divided by 2ga. This is the formula. And what is Fs? So Fs is form factor. Fs is equal to form factor. And for rectangular shape, this Fs is equal to 6/5. And what is about G? So G is modulus of rigidity. We'll find it from property table, and A is the area. So you can see the height is 300 and width is 100. So 300 in meter is 0.300 and height is, width is 0.1. So this will be the area. Okay, now G, for G we'll go to the property table, and you can see here that this is the property table, and we have 6061 T6, and G is 26 gigapascal. So we'll write the value 26 gigapascal, 26 into 10 raised to power 9 pascal. Okay, now we have all the value, V is there, all the value is there. So you can just put it 0 to from L and X start from 0 to X start from till 1. So 0 to 1, Fs is 6 over 5 v square. So v is 150 into 10 raised to power 3 whole square into dx divided by 2 times g is 26 into 10 raised to power 9, and area is 0.3 multiplied by 0.1. That will give you strain energy due to shear force. So when you calculate this, so you will get strain energy due to shearing comes out to be 17.31 joules. So this is the strain energy due to shearing. Now we'll find the strain energy due to bending. Strain energy due to bending. And we know that strain energy due to bending is equal to integral from 0 to L m square dx divided by 2EI. What is the value of E? So E can be taken from this table. Again, you can see E is 68.9 gigapascal. So I will write E is 68.9 into 10 raised to power 9 pascal. And what about I? I is the second moment of inertia for this rectangular section. It is equal to 1 over 12 breadth, which is 100 millimeter, and that in meter is 0.1, and height is 0.3, and it will be Q. So when you calculate, it will give you 0.225 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meter power 4 there. So you can just put it in this formula. Strain energy due to bending will be equal to integral from 0 to L. Moment is 150. You can see 150 into 10 raised to power 3 x. Clear? Why 150? Because this, the unit will be kilonewton into meter. So in order to convert into newton into meter, we will multiply 10 raised to power x into whole square into dx divided by 2EI. E is 68.9 into 10 raised to power 9, and I is 0.225 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Okay. Now, if you further simplify it and you will get, if you take all these constant, 150 into 10 raised to power 3 whole square divided by 2 multiplied by 68.9 into 10 raised to power 9 multiplied by 0.225 into 10 raised to power minus 3 integral of 0 to L, and L will be 1 because you can see x start from 0 till x is equal to 1. We will left with x square dx. And again, when you solve this, you will get this value 725.689 integral of 0 to 1 x square into dx. And that will be 725.689. This will be x cubed divided by 3 and limit from 0 to 1. So that will be 725.689 into 1 cube minus 0 cube divided by 3 will give you strain energy due to bending. And lastly, when you solve this, you will get the strain energy due to bending comes out to be 241.90 joules. Now this is the strain energy due to bending. So strain energy due to shear is this, and strain energy due to bending is this. So we know that total strain energy, which is UI, is equal to UI due to shear plus UI due to bending. So add them both, 17.31 plus 241.90, and that will give you 259.20 joules. So this is the total strain energy. Now we will move above, and you can see due to this load 150, this beam will deflect like this. So its original axis. So this is the distance delta, that delta B will move, vertical displacement of delta B. So due to this external load, we have external, due to this external work will be done, and the work done will be stored in the form of strain energy, which will be equal to 1 over 2 this load 150 into 10 raised to power 3 multiplied by this delta B. Clear? So I will write it, strain energy due to external load slash work will be equal to UE, and that will be equal to 1 over 2, 150 kilonewton was the load, into delta B. Okay, now we have both these equations. So by conservation of energy, this external work that is done on the object will be stored in the form of internal strain energy. So UE will be equal to UI. So UE is 1 over 2 into 10 raised to power 1 over 2 into 150 into 10 raised to power 3 multiplied by delta B will be equal to 259.20 joules, and delta B will be equal to 259.20 multiplied by 2 divided by 150 into 10 raised to power 3. So when you solve this, you will get this vertical displacement of point B comes out to be 3.456 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meter, or this delta B in meter, vertical displacement of point B will be equal to 3.46 millimeter, which is the answer of our this question. And that was all about this problem 14-30. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help me in growing further. Thank you for your support.